G'day guys, welcome back to the Fat Bloke's Kitchen for another cheap ass installment from us. What I'm putting together here is a absolute cracker. Have a look at this bad boy. I picked it up this morning from the butcher. Look at that. Hey, if you don't like pig, you're an idiot. That's all I can say. It does not get better than that. That is a boned shoulder. The butcher did it because I'm a lazy bastard. Generally, actually, I like to cook it on the bone. It helps keep it a bit moister. However, there's plenty of fat content in there. It's been rolled to keep it together, to keep the fat and moisture inside. I'm going to slow roast this bad boy. It is so easy, this thing, yet the flavour is absolutely cracking. I've got the oven cranked up. Now, it's starting off a little bit warm. Reason is I want to get a bit of the old crackling going here, and I'll just get that going, and then we'll just bang away she goes. Bob's your uncle. It will turn out perfectly. You can't stuff this up at all, the beauty of slow roasting. I've started off with what's called a mirepoix. A mirepoix is basically some root vegetables in the bottom here to help keep this bad boy here moist. Also add some flavour in there. We're going to make gravy out of that bit at the end. But I don't think I'm going to bother showing you all that because that's hours down the track. I'm just going to show you in this little installment how to get this thing cracking and on the go. And then bang, you do what you like. Have a few quiet ones, whatever you like. Good as gold. All right, as you can see, I've started already. I've got some roughly chopped onion. Yes, I've kept the skin on. I've got some roughly chopped carrot. Haven't bothered too much. All I'm going to add to that is a little bit of this. We all know what this is. This is celery. Look how easy. No skills involved in this whatsoever. Bit of celery. In she goes. Bob's your uncle. Hello. Look at that. Magnif. Simple as that. I'm just going to add a little bit of garlic now. Just for a bit of the old garlic flavour. You never go wrong with that. What am I going to do? I'm not going to get too mathematical. Three or four bulbs. Just crush it up. Cloves, I should say, not bulbs. God, Jesus, that'd be a bit rich, wouldn't it? Oh, leaving the skin on, not worrying it too much, you know? Because the skin will actually help brown that sauce at the end if we're going to use it for gravy, which in this instance we are. Just put that out of the way. Get rid of this. And you know what? It's pretty much as easy as just that. All I'm going to do now, add a little bit of aromatics to get some more flavour in there. We know what that is. Sage. Bit of sage out of the garden, you know what, and because we're the Fat Blokes, we don't care too much. I haven't washed it or anything like that. But I'll have a quick scan, make sure there's no nasties crawling on there. We don't really need any extra protein. Not that, as I said, not that we worry too much, don't get precious. But anyway, just have a quick scan, make sure there's nothing living there that shouldn't be that we're going to cook up. Looks good as gold. A little bit more, why not? I've got it here. Bang. And sage and pork. Match made in heaven. Absolutely cracking. Can't go wrong with that. Now, I've got a little bit of other stuff while I was out there. I saw it and I thought I'm going to grab some of that too. Time. My old mate, time. We love time. Not the clock. Time. Fantastic. Whack it on there. You could use a little bit of lemon thyme if you wanted to. I've got plenty of that out there, but I just grabbed that because I was there. Just a little bit. All good. Right. Look at that. A bed of mirepoix plus a few other aromatics in there to enhance this bad boy. We're going to whack him on top. How easy is that? Look. Now, all we've got to do is add some liquid to this thing because it's going to cook for hours. We don't want it to dry out. And also, it's going to help with our sauce at the end, our gravy, if you like. I'm going to grab myself a bottle of the 1999 Semillon Chardonnay from Cofields, if you don't mind. Why am I grabbing this? Basically because it's as dead as a doornail. It's not having a crack at the winery, incidentally. I stupidly didn't drink it when I needed to, and it was ready. And as you'll notice, it's got one of these old-fashioned cork things. Christ, what were the bloody Portuguese thinking when they invented corks, eh? Anyway, until the old Stelvin came along. Incidentally, a bit of trivia for you. The old screw tops, the French hated, don't they? You know who invented the bloody things? The French. Frogs. Wouldn't have a clue, would they? They still hate them and they invented them. That's what was called the Stelvin cap. It was a French invention. Anyway, forget all that. Bit of trivial rubbish. So what we're going to do, we're going to rip the cork in half because it's imperative to stuff up at some point when you're cooking in the Two Fat Blokes kitchen. All right? Because otherwise it just looks too easy, doesn't it? All right, we'll try and get the rest of this out. And it's not going to play nicely to us. It's falling to shreds. Reverse angle here. Watch that, eh? Pop her in. In she goes. Snabby grammar. All right, glug, glug, glug. Bit of cough, fantastic. It's good for the old protein. Give her a bit of a drink. Oh, whoops, whoop, too much. Oh, no, oh. As you can see, I'm not really too fussed about that. I'm not measuring it out exactly. It's cooking for hours. You wouldn't really use a bottle of grog, right? That's just getting a bit silly. You might put a cup or two and some stock in there as well. But what else am I going to do with that? So why not plonk it on? This is where it comes down to the fact that it really doesn't matter too much, right? Simple, nothing clever about it. Remove the cork, as I said, we don't really want the cork in there. All I'm going to do now, a little bit of olive oil. I don't know what that's all about. Anyway, squirt that on top. Bang. Imperative to get... It's a bit of the old salt. Got to have a bit of the old salt. If you don't have the salt, not going to help with that. And we all know there's two things that make all crap food taste good. Doesn't matter what you do, as long as you're putting in salt and butter, it'll come to cake. A bit of a mash over. Away you go. Oh, hello. Reminds me of Saturday. No, not going to go there. All right, so that's all good. That is literally ready to go in the oven. 4 or 5 hours. Simple. 6, 7. If you have a few too many of those, just slow it down, go to 8. Doesn't matter. It's really simple. Just keep an eye on it. Keep it wet. If that dries down, I'm going to add some stock to that because I've got far too much wine already. I'm not getting too mathematical about it. This is just simple, slow roasted, into the oven. What temperature are you going to ask? I've got it a bit hot to start with. It's sitting on 200 at the moment. I'll probably leave it on there for 10 minutes and bang down, she's going to go to 130. And then it's just going to fester away nicely. If it looks like it's getting a bit heavy on the dark side, I'm going to cover it up. Just play it by ear, see how you go. It's not hard, it's easy. If you stuff it up, don't worry, it'll still taste all right because that sauce there will drown it back up again and get it. It's a cheat's way of doing it, it all works. Anyway, till next time, I'll catch you around in the Fat Bloke's Kitchen. I'm out.